Hi, I am Dr. Saqib Mansoor, and today I will discuss with you GSI finger. The GSI finger is inability to flex the finger at the distal interphalangeal joint due to the injury to this tendon, the flexor digitorum profundus, and mostly this ring finger is involved. You could see this. But it's a definition. GSI finger, a rugby finger, is an evolution of the flexor digitorum profundus tendon from its distal attachment, that is, insertion on the distal phalanx base of it. The ring finger is mostly affected as ring finger projects the farthest the grasping position. It is more prone to avulsion of the flexor digitorum profundus tendon, resulting in an inability to flex at the distal interphalangeal joint. Here you could see this is the distal interphalangeal joint, and here you could see this. I will tell you the normal anatomy of the muscle flexor digitorum profundus. You could see this index finger is normally involved. It cannot be flexed. So this is the relevant anatomy. Flexor digitorum profundus is one of the deep muscles of the anterior, the flexor compartment of the forearm. It is a hybrid or the composite muscle innervated by two different nerves. Medial half is innervated by the ulnar nerve, and the lateral half is innervated by anterior interosseous branch of the median nerve. It is the main gripping muscle extended position of the wrist. It is the only flexor of the distal interphalangeal joint of the digital second to fifth digit. This is the only flexor because it crosses the distal interphalangeal joint. Here you could see the muscle. Beautiful picture. Flexor digitorum profundus. Here you could see this. This it is going down, coming into the palm. And this is the insertion, flexor digitorum profundus tendon, and it gets going there. It gets attached or inserted into the base of the distal phalanx. Mechanism of injury. As discussed earlier, the ring finger is mostly affected at its point of insertion, which is the fragile point in the tendon. The injury takes place to finger if it is caught in jersey of a player, whereas the little finger continues to flex, and the extension of flexor digitorum profundus takes place as the tackled player runs away. A powerful extension while contraction of flexor digitorum profundus results in avulsion of the flexor digitorum profundus tendon. So, what is the clinical presentation with the jersey finger? Inability to actively flex at the distal interphalangeal joint. Inability to bend one or more of the joints in a finger. There could be pain and edema there around finger and palm. Numbness in the fingertip. Tenderness along the palmar side of the hand. Swelling and pain at the fingertip can be seen. Excruciating at the severe pain in the palm just before base of the finger can be sign of can be a sign of a minimum rupture. So the diagnostic procedures. Important diagnostic procedures used in cases of high doubt of GSI finger in the athletes having finger pain include physical examination, X-rays, ultrasound, and MRI. MRI can helps in comprehensive evaluation of the injury and can help in determining extent of the tendon retraction, though it is used rarely. The following test is used. The physical examination also shows that injured finger remains in extension compared to other digits. Very diagnostic. Besides, the retracted tendon may be palpated proximally to the site of avulsion. Flexion of distal interphalangeal joint is lacking, along with grip and flexion against resistance being very painful. Anteroposterior and lateral views of the X-ray can show a bony fragment. Ultrasound is commonly fundamental for evaluation of tendon retraction and suggest additional treatment. So you see, ultrasound is the key to this diagnosis. It is very necessary to carry out an ultrasound. So I told you already, MRI is rarely carried out but may be performed to determine the bigger tendon bone distance for more precisely. So what is the differential diagnosis, TD? The phalanx rupture and the muscle sprain. These two conditions are to be differentiated from the flexor digitorum profundus injury or the jersey finger. What is the non-surgical management? When the flexor tendon is merely partially torn, which occurs very rarely, surgery may be may not be essential. The patient can be advised to wear a splint to help stabilize finger and allow damaged tendon to repair on its own. The discomfort or pain caused by tendon injury is relieved using non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Usage of the splint will be supplemented by physical therapy to help restore strength and movement to affected finger after immobilization period of 1 to 3 weeks and rest. So you could see use of the physiotherapy. So the non those now the final and utmost hallmark of the treatment, surgical management. The treatment option for JSC finger is predominantly surgical, and the conservative management is merely considered when surgery cannot be carried out due to the complications. Surgery is essential to re-establish a pain-free active range of motion of the affected digit. Surgical management is conclusive management and is to be carried out as soon as possible, generally within 3 weeks of the injury. Surgical salvage processes for late presentation comprises distal interpharyngeal joint tenodesis, arthrodesis, and staged tendon reconstructions. Various surgical techniques are brought into use for the treatment of avulsion injuries of flexor digitorum profundus that include the following: suture anchor repair. Then next is the bunal pullout suture technique. Next is the tendon repair with the incorporation of the volar plate. It is the most recent of the discussed techniques. This tendon repair with the incorporation of the volar plate. Then is the pullout suture procedure is by tradition the most frequently used technique, this pullout suture procedure. The patients are able to resume normal and sport activity within 8 to 12 weeks, 2 to 3 months, with an effective postoperative rehabilitation. So the physiotherapy in the last, there is 8 to 12 weeks of loss of play in athletes after the surgical treatment. So big loss was 3 months. A sport specific hand rehabilitation protocol is followed with respect to their position during play. That comprises dorsal blocking splint, passive range of motion exercises in the early postoperative period, active oriented ROM, or that is range of motion exercises, the strengthening exercises, and then in the last tendon gliding exercises. So the lot of finger deformities and the diseases are discussed, and I tell you now in the last that this Jesse finger and the mallet finger differs in that Jesse finger involves the flexor tendon and the mallet finger involves the extensor tendon rupture. Thank you very much. Stay tuned.